Hello, everybody. Today is the day we're going to talk about different things that you can use in order to be able to create your weaving projects or wigs or whatever you're going to do. Today, my name is Paula Abdul, and I'm going to get into a subject that a lot of people do not want to talk about, but is a very real in this world. Okay. First, we're going to talk about weaving and extensions, okay? As you see, extensions can come in flame retardant textures. Queen, this one is by Queen Deluxe. It's 100% kinecolon hair. It's flame retardant fiber as well. This is also a kinecolon type texture, and it's also a flame retardant fiber as well. Okay, and some weave come on wefts already handmade and already created for you. And you don't have to do all the work in order to create it. This is a master parting piece here to be able to close out a wig or a weave at the top. Once you get to the top and there's a big scalp that's at the end, or you have a problem where you need to cover at the top where your wefts may be showing, this is what a master parting piece looks like, and that's why it's there. I took some wigs and some weave that I had left over, and I put it out here, and the reason why is because I want to give people understanding that wigs are also weave too. Okay, and you see the wefts that you see on the extension. If you can see that, I'm holding it out here in the light. As you can see, the wefts is on the extension, and you can see the way that they are created. Okay, and they are made to be able to sew on to a braid or a weft that you have created. If you're doing it piece by piece and you are piecing your wig together on somebody's head without having to go through putting it on a net. A weave is a weave regardless whether it's on a net or whether it's not. Okay, all weaves and wigs may come in different colors and different types of colors and color schemes. Some have mixtures of colors in them. This is human hair. Some have mixtures of colors in them, and some don't. This is black, mixed with blonde, mixed with brown, mixed all different kinds of colors. And you can also find weave in those different types of colors. You can find weave in the darker kind of colors that may be mixed with darker brown, and colors that may be black, jet black, and many different other colors. Weave can come in all different colors. Weave can come in dark colors like this, that are jet black, that are real dark, okay, and everything. But as you notice that when you look at the weave construction or whatever, some may be on a weft, some may be on a master parting piece. Others may be hooked to things to be able to add in certain areas to cover up certain areas of a person's weave that might be showing where the weft may be. But however else that wig or weave is made, whether it's coming in short and it has colors in it and it still has weft, these have wefts or whatever, two-tone, ombre, whatever the color that you may be getting or you may be buying, does not change it for being a weave. A weave is a weave regardless of what color that you may be using. Whether you may be using brown and a darker color or silkier texture, it's still constructed on a net, okay? And I had to take some wigs apart and so that you can be able to see an example of what's going on with it. But all weave and all wigs and extensions is still stemming from the same place. Whether they on a weft, and you have wefts, these are some old wefts, but they are also wefts, okay? Whether the hair is done with light color, like blonde, a light color like this. I've had this wear for a couple of years. But even if it's coming in blonde or whether it's coming in a dark color, it does not change what it is. If you're buying it and it's coming in a pack, Okay, like this. Well, this is a ponytail. These are ponytails by HP Mink. One. All color. And we're going to get a color, a close look at that. That's one, okay, by one. HP Mink. And T27613. And this one is called The One. It's a, by Sepia. It's a drawstring ponytail. This one is in a light golden blonde. You see it curls a little bit at the end or whatever, and it's meant to be used as a ponytail. Whatever color that you buy in your ponytails, and whether you buy them in black or you buy them in a brown, a light brown, or blonde, or whatever color it is, it doesn't change what it is. When you're buying hair in a pack, and even if it's bought loosely, it still is weave. The only difference is that this weave is not put on the neck. Okay, if you're putting any hair or any extension in your hair and braiding it in there, okay, or you taking it, wefting it, and sewing it in there, it doesn't change it from being what it is. It's still hair extension, no matter what it is that you're doing. Okay, whether you're using clips, whether you're using needle and thread to sew it in. Threads can come in light colors. Threads can come in dark colors with the needles. Okay, you can buy the needles separately. They can come in dark colors. You can also use weave and to put it in. You can latch hook it and use a latch hook like this or whatever. Whatever method that you choose to use and whatever type of thread that you're using or not using, it doesn't change it from being a weave. A weave is a weave regardless of whatever it is that you're doing. It doesn't change it from being a weave, whether it's done on black people or white people. A weave is a weave in the end. So, I'm putting out this video to inform because many people do not know the difference, okay, and don't understand what's going on. They think just because they got braids in their hair, but they don't have the wefts in their hair, okay, on a bundle in their hair, they don't have extensions in their hair or they don't have a weave. But you got a weave is a weave regardless of whatever particular type of style you use, whether you're using a fall, a wig, a weave, or whatever it is, when you're doing crochet or when you're doing some other type of texture style that you want to use, it's still a weave in the end, okay. These are some other different types of hair that you can use and different colors. This is the Brazilian wool. And as you see, it also looks like hair too. If you get up close up on it, it looks like hair. It don't really look like no knitting wool. It looks like hair, literally. And this one right here is in 70G or whatever it is. This is a golden blonde. Okay, you can also buy them in packs like this. You can buy them and darker packs. So that says 1% acrylic hand machine and knitting yarn. But even though it might look like that, look at the way it look. It looks like hair. Okay. And people are using it. They may use wool. They've been using it for 2,000 or 3,000 some years to use it to braid into people's hair, to do extensions or braids or crochet or dreadlocks or whatever they're doing. That's black. Okay, this one right here is a purple color, okay, for people who want to be, you know, when they want to add color into their hair. This one is called the Brazilian wool, okay, that's what it's called. That's called a Brazilian wool hair, okay. So however you are using it or adding it into your hair or whatever, hair is hair in the end of the day. However you using it. This one also is a brown. This one is a brown. Okay. It's coming in a brown or a light brown. For people who try to do their hair. Brazilian wool hair. Could come in all different styles. It's a hand acrylic. 1% a hand. Acrylic hand machine and knitting yarn. Okay. And some people call kinecolon hair acrylic hair as well. But in general, okay, as we look over it and we look at the different types of wigs and weave and extension packs and how they could come and so many other different types of packs that they could come, get an understanding of if however you're doing it, whether you're dolling a wig For a doll or for a person or for a human, weave can come in all different kind of ways, okay? But as we examine, if you look at the weave, let's look at the examination of that. You notice that the weft, okay, is added on to elastic, and it got all kind of other stuff in it. It got netting and everything else that's going on with it. But a weave is really actually just a pre-style weave where a person does not have to do the weave style that they want to do and go to a beautician and have it fixed. They can just go to a store and buy the weave, okay? Buy the weave and then put the weave on their head and it comes out as a full style, okay? So whether you're wearing a wig or a sew-in or braids or crochet or whatever it may be, it does not change it after we look at it again, okay, and look at what it looks like. It doesn't change it from being a weave. So it doesn't make any sense to be trying to laugh and poke fun at somebody else because you got braids and you got stitches in your hair, but they got a sew-in and their braids is calling their hair extension and fake hair and weave, but you said that yours is not, okay, because it's all in the end, it's all. If it's coming out of a bag and you had to buy it or you had to order it and then sort in your hair, glue it in, braid it in, crochet it in, or whatever it is, it's still an extension style. It's still a weave. I don't care if you're taking and putting some clips on the wefts and clipping in your hair or whatever you're doing. It's still in the end. It's a weave in the end. Okay? So I'm going to close it and end it on there. With that, if you are competing in pageants, remember that every time you compete in a pageant, they're going to give you a number. This is just a leftover number that I have from Supreme Me. But when you're competing in a pageant, they will give you a number. Sometimes everybody doesn't get sashes and to compete in pageants immediately. Some do and some won't. Okay, depending on the pageant. Sometimes you, if you were going to a state pageant or city pageant, they may give you a sash that says Los Angeles or California, or if it's a state, it's California, Idaho, Oklahoma, New York, New Jersey, Florida, or whatever it is. If you're doing a state pageant or a national pageant, you may get a sash. If you are doing a preliminary pageant or regional, you may not have a sash. They may give you a number, okay? And some national pageants may give you a number too until you win a certain title. And when you win that title, then they give you a sash. So if you're competing in a pageant, remember that they give you a number, and sometimes it has a safety pin hooked onto it or a pin or something like that so that you can get an idea of that. Sometimes people don't see it. I don't understand that all the time when you compete in a pageant, you don't all the time wear your sash. Sometimes you will, sometimes you won't. Okay, now we're going to get over and go into this makeup thing here. Now, the thing I'm still trying to stress is that find makeup. When you find a makeup, you can find makeup in small little palettes just like this. Okay, this is a lip gloss. And this one is made by Aziza 2. Okay, this is made by Aziza 2. A-Z-I-Z-A. Aziza 2. And they make lip gloss. This particular palette is a palette as well. Okay, this palette right here that I'm holding in my hand is made by Flipster. Okay, and it also has colors in it. Like I said, colors are colors. And if you can find those colors in whatever city, state, and town that you in, find what you can to be able to try to help you help yourself have some makeup and some shadows to be able to use. We don't all live in the same countries and on the same continents, but it's colors that's around, okay? This is a very small shadow palette here, okay? I think I dropped it. Sorry about that. But this is a very small palette here, okay? This is for young people, boys, girls, children, all ages. This is a very small one. If you can find one that had the small, that got the colors in it that you may need, that you feel that you need, by all means necessary, find that palette. Get that palette. Don't just pass up palettes in makeup stores, jewelry stores, wear stores, beauty supplies, or wherever it is. If you see a palette, you feel that color that you need it, get it. That way you don't have to go into people's pageants asking them for their colors and their makeup when you can be able to have your own. Makeup can be affordable. This cost me like a dollar at a wig store. Okay, it was not expensive. Okay, this makeup powder right here cost me maybe about a dollar at like a 99-cent store or whatever. These are not expensive palettes, okay? This one right here is coming from Clean Color. You can see it. It's called Clean, by the K, K-L-E-A-N-C-O-L-O-R, Clean Color. And this one right here is called Girls Talk 3. You see it, Girls Talk 3. And Girls Talk 3 is, this is also a shadow palette. Okay, so that's a shadow palette as well. Okay, if I remove the lid so you can get an idea of it, those are some colors. You see the silvers, blacks, you see golds, you see a few reds, you see a few lip glosses, and some maybe some powders that's up in there. That's different colors. I've used this palette before. But the colors are there, okay? So be looking for colors that you may need to be able to do shadows for you or for your daughter or for someone else, because they are out there, okay? They may not necessarily be Maybelline or MAC or whatever, but a palette is a palette at the end of the day. This one right here is made by Makeover Essentials, okay? M-E, Makeover Essentials. M-E, you see it, okay? And this is a quite large palette right here, but it is a makeup palette, okay, as well, for if you want to get shadows. Okay, let me open this. Okay, now I'm holding this in my hand, and you can see that there are some colors that's in there, okay? They have the lights, they have the darks, they have the earth tones as well, and a few powders that's within them, okay? This is a palette that's about a couple of years old, but I still have it, and I just want to show people that it's makeup that's out there. I paid about $10 for this in downtown Los Angeles. This one right here is called Makeup Essentials, and I found it downtown Los Angeles. And so I just want to show it, okay, because I don't live in the same part of the world that you may live in all the time, but if it's makeup out there, please find it, because when you're going to do these makeup tutorials with anybody, you need to have makeup, okay, to be able to do something. This one right here is also by Makeup Essentials, M-E, Makeup Essentials, okay, and these are some glosses, okay, you see the pinks and the what is that? Some bronze colors, a whole lot of beautiful colors that's up in there. Okay, and the little pinks and stuff like that. And those are some lip glosses. You can find lip glosses and stuff. So be looking around. Even though small palettes are still, you know, that those small palettes are important. Okay, so get a hold to them. Okay, if you can get a hold to them. This one right here is a, this is by Maybelline. This one called Me. M-E with a cap with apostrophe on it. Okay. And this one is by Maybelline. Now, this one right here is what you call a powder. Okay. It's just a powder. Okay. Like a powder that you can use with a loose powder or whatever, or a makeup powder that you may need. Okay. Things like that. Those powders come in small little clasp little clothes. You can open and close it just like that. Those are important. You can find those at some drugstores and some other little beauty supply stores if you want to. Places like that. This one right here is also one. Now, this one right here is called Muse Diamond Eyeshadow. Okay? That's what it's called. M-U-S-E. Muse Diamond Eyeshadow. These, I only paid like about $3.99 for that. You see that? Okay. It was not expensive. Okay. So, colors, the blacks, the silvers, the greens, the blues, and all that. You see them in red, green, whatever, to be able to create your little cosplay makeups and stuff. You got to have, I already showed the brushes. You got to have something that you can be able to use to be able to put some makeup on. Okay, so, you know, don't be discriminating against colors if you need those colors, okay? I'm opening up this palette here, Okay, so you can get a closer look at this. You see that? So there, those are your blacks and silvers and pinks right there. Then you got your whites and your little golds and stuff and bronzes. There's some other little deep silvers and dark gray silvers and stuff like that. With some blues and greens and stuff. Those are some reds and some pinks and purples right there. Those are some oranges, okay, and greens and some light yellow shadows. That's right in one palette. Right there. Okay? That right there. That you can use. So don't be passing up makeup. Okay? If you need the makeup, buy the makeup. Okay? That way you don't have to be paying all that extra money to be having people. Look at that. Girl Talk 3 by Clean Color. And me. Okay, by Makeover Essentials. Okay, me by Maybelline. And then this palette, I don't even know what the name of it is, but hey, it got makeup in there. Names, hey, I ain't gonna crap my style. If I need to find some makeup and I need some colors, hey, I'm gonna find the colors I need. Okay, so you'll see it right there. Okay, those are makeup palettes. I'll lay some more out for you. So you can get an idea. And, you know, while I'm doing makeup, because I'm going to be doing some superhero makeup, so how to do Supergirl, how to do Wonder Girl, how to do, I did my Green Lantern makeup and things like that. So if you want to join in and, you know, watch the videos and then pause the videos and stop them and then go back to them or whatever so that you can be able to figure out, okay, how did Paula do that? Then you will have some ideas. But still, I'm not going to just start doing makeup tutorials right at this moment because I know people still out there still trying to find this product. But by the end of next week, I will start to do makeup tutorials again. And so I want to give people a chance to be able to get their products and then come along and with us. If you already have products, great. And everything, but if you can just find a palette that's only $3, $4, $5, foundation, a concealer, a few brushes, some lip gloss, some lipstick and lip colors, you don't have to have a lot, but come on back and do makeup with us, and then I can show you a few tricks that you can use to be able to do cosplay and some other things or whatever. So I'm doing this for my fans, and I'm doing this for other people. So remember, makeup can come in small palettes. Like I said before, start looking for them. Hair, I got this hair. I ordered it off eBay. Okay, the Brazilian wool. You see it right there. So start looking, okay? To get all of these, okay, all of these, it cost me about $50-something dollars. I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 gold ones. I got two purple ones. I got two brown ones and two black ones right there. You see it. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 of those Brazilian wools for under $50. I know you ain't gonna believe that. Okay, but I did. Okay, now these particular ponytails by one. Okay, you see it. Okay, they only like $14. Okay, $14. I don't know if you can see the price. Okay, but hey, it's $14.99. That's how much I paid for it. Okay, and everything. So it's not that expensive. Now this particular pack right here by Queen Deluxe Connectalon, $2.99. $2.99. Not lying. Queen 100% Connectalon flame retardant. You see it right there. Item braid, item 600-6002, color M27.613. Okay, and that's a light color. So if you're looking for a light hair to braid your hair, and braid your daughter hair, but you got light skin, paper sack tan skin, blonde hair, blue eyes, green eyes, whatever. Hey, it's hair out there. Okay, find it and come on back, and I will teach you how to be able to use it. Okay, if you're trying to be able to figure out how to do this thing, I am going to show how to do braids on screen and stuff too and everything. So yes, you may need some thread. By all means necessary, try to get some. Okay, and you may need some needles. Okay, you see the little needles? that's in it. I'm holding it up, the weave thread. You may need some needles to be able to figure that out, how to do that thing, okay, and everything. But you got to have something, okay? You have to have something to work with. For the ones who need to figure out how to do a crochet, I'm going to work with a crochet wig, okay, and put together. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take these ponytails, I'm going to assemble them, and I'm going to make a ponytail wig, and I'm going to start it off. And then after that, I'm going to take these other hair right here and then add that in the net in the frontal and make a frontal right there on screen. Okay, and I'm going to take the time it takes in order to be able to show you how to be able to do that little knotting technique that I did when I made Reby. Remember when I made Reby? So that's what I'm going to be doing. I'm going to be showing you how to be able to put this stuff into your wig to be able to create it to get it to look like how my wigs came out to look. Okay, so just remember that. Okay, and we're going to end this with, Ariana Grande's song, "One Less Problem." So go on review. You need to collect the lawn, hey. That's that one. You need thread and needles. You need some web hair. Whatever color you want to use, whether it's brown, blonde, golden blonde, platinum. Darker browns, jet black, whatever color you need, golden browns, whatever it is. Okay, get your hair together. You gonna use a Brazilian wheel? Use it. Use whatever texture you feel like is most important to you. We're gonna learn how to get it in there. Okay. Find your makeup. Okay. Find it. All right. And I'm Paula Abdul. They go here and round, rocking her weed. All right, so I just want to break that down for you, that however you getting your hair in, or maybe you want to do a ponytail, okay, and add it into your hair. We're gonna get to that. I'm gonna do one for you, and I'm gonna use a wig as an example on how to get the ponytail on there and all that stuff. We're gonna work on that. So for the ones who still having a little problem and trying to figure out how to get it in there, we gonna get past these little problems, okay? Because it can be done. Okay, it can be done. Thank you. I'm Paula Abdul, and I also do pageants, beauty pageants, face pageants, glitz pageants, and I also do semi-glitz. Also, if you're going to be doing makeup or whatever, you don't want to get all your outfits messed up, and especially if you are a beginner at it, find a robe, a kimono, or find something that you don't mind getting something on and then putting it into a washer and dryer. You may need a roll, okay, or something like that that you may be able to want to use, or something like that, or a t-shirt or something. I got this a Supreme Me little shirt that I use sometimes too, or whatever. You can use a lot of different, it's a lot of different things, a t-shirt, a clear t-shirt, or something like that. Whatever you can use that can be able to help you. If not, you can get another type of t-shirt, just a t-shirt, okay. You may need just a t-shirt. Whatever type of t-shirt that you need to use, just use a t-shirt. any color t-shirt to work, whether it's black, whether it's blue, whether it's blonde, white, whatever. If you don't mind getting a little powder on it, or, you know, if some makeup fall on it or whatever, you can just easily throw it into the washer and dryer and wash it. That's cool. Okay. It don't matter about what kind of t-shirt it is. A t-shirt is good too. Okay, so that you don't have to be getting makeup all over your clothes and stuff, and then ruining any gowns or anything that you're trying to do. So, you know, just find something, okay, whatever it takes, and then we're going to try to work on that and see if we can be able to get this makeup situation together for the ones who are having a hard time with it. I'm Paula Abdul, and I'll be your host, and I'll be working with trying to teach you how to do some of these makeups and how to be able to work with some of these weaves and stuff. For the ones who are having a difficult time. For the ones who are not having a difficult time, watch too, because you can still learn. Thank you. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. That's beautiful Ariana Grande right there. We started off with some of her wigs and weaves and with the rare Ariana and some other ones. So we're going to be working on a lot of other different looks and stuff. And thank you. God bless you. Have a great day. Thank you.